Hi.
Hi, Captain Jim. Yep. Come right in.
Try to get the wheel on the whole shield.
Hello, sir. Anybody has any questions? Captain Duffey loves to answer questions.
Yeah, I do. That's true.
He just answered one.
And if I don't know the answer, I'll make up an answer you'll believe. Believe me.
How do you translate knots into miles per hour?
By looking at the scissor on there. 1.2 miles an hour is a knot. If memory serves me. Right, Smitty?
A mile and an eighth?
Mile and an eighth, yeah. 1.2. If you want to round it.
6,008 feet.
What's the trickiest part of the lake to navigate?
Depends entirely on conditions, wind, and so forth. We are always very careful everywhere. But we're always careful up here at the Witches and also at the turn going by Eagle Island. You know, and that's fairly narrow there. Those are the areas. Coming into Wolfboro, there's one big shallow area we watch out for. But the most challenging part of this ship is always docking. Because of all the massive steel, it's the biggest sailboat on the lake, we like to say. And if there's any wind at all, it becomes a lot of fun.
Yes.
But most of the route we take, most of it, is, you know, fairly deep water by design. There's not a lot of tugboats in this lake.
Can I hold up beside you?
Yeah, of course you can. What, which way? Oh, here. Oh, okay, sure. There you go. Wow. Paparazzi here. Oh, yeah. Got everybody? All right.
What's your favorite instrument to use?
My favorite what?
Instrument to use.
Oh, probably guitar.
The horn.
That's right. Actually, the thing I think all the captains, three of us here, would agree that is the most indispensable is the rudder angle indicator there that tells us the angle of the view from over there. See the saucer there and the knob is just right.
Yeah, how are you?
Well, when we turn the vessel, that goes with us and tells us the angle of our rudder. And that's extremely important for a ship of this size because, you know, you may go out in a runabout and you turn the wheel, but you turn the wheel like this, nothing happens very fast in the ship. So we need to know where the rudder is. That's,
well,
I think everybody
would agree that
that's
what
we're about to do. Believe me, on a foggy night, I wouldn't want to be done by radar and GPS, but if they said you can only keep one instrument and that's it, that might be something.
That would be when you pick. Well, that's fascinating. I wouldn't guess that, so thank you for telling me.
You're welcome.
What's the coolest thing you've seen in the water?
You know, it's funny. Most of the neat things I've seen in the water, I've seen in my own boat. I saw a fish of cat swim across the front of the river.
Really?
I saw a deer swimming out to an island. Yeah. I think the things that I see on this ship that are most amazing is what some people do without regard to the size of the ship. You'll see parents will pull their kids in the tube in front of us because they want to get a picture with the big ship in the background. That kid falls off the tube, there's nothing we can do. You don't stop, you know. The nice thing, and Captain Smith has been here almost as long as I've been alive, so he'd know more than I, but it's never the same. You know, it's always changed. No two cruises are the same, that's for yourself.
That's very cool.
He was great. My mom and Marie were buddies.
Oh, yeah. Right now we're 10.8 miles an hour, but 10.8 miles an hour on this ship is different than in your car.
Definitely.
Take the wheel.
Oh, my goodness.